Hi everyone, Cut the Knee, Rate Tano here, the internet's busiest music nerd, and it is time for a review of the new Dan Deacon album,
Mystic Familiar.
New album from composer, songwriter, singer, Daniel Deacon, finally following up his 2015 record Gliss Riffer for Domino Records. In the meantime, since that release though, he has put out a few soundtrack drops. Despite Dan's massive success in the indie scene over the past decade or so, it's still been a long time since I have loved a Dan Deacon record. The issues I've had with his recent works are more case by case, but I still keep coming back to every new project for the same reasons. Because on paper, what he's doing should be right up my alley. Bright, psychedelic electronics built up into these thick pieces inspired by classical minimalism. Yes, we're listening to that. So once again, I'm crossing my fingers on Mystic Familiar, hoping that this time it's really gonna blow me away. I did enjoy the album's teasers, but still didn't want to set myself up once again for disappointment. But for me, Mystic Familiar is pretty much expectations met and slightly exceeded. For one, this thing is easily one of Dan's most trippy and well-mixed records. I love the variety of timbres employed on this project, keeping these pieces from feeling like these uniform bricks of sound without any real dynamics. The fluttering strings, the pronounced pianos, pounding drums, and the synths that are of various textures. Then there's the vocals, which for Dan are a bit more upfront, a bit more clear, a bit more intimate. He doesn't seem as quick to manipulate them as heavily so that they just sound alien or overly cartoonish, which ultimately I think is a good thing. It adds more of a human component to what he does. Mystic Familiar is a pretty tight record too at 44 minutes, all of which are broken down into 11 individual tracks, but a handful of them do segue into each other pretty tightly, creating this four-part art piece right in the middle of the record. It pretty much runs like Dan Deacon's USA piece off of his America record, but it's not nearly as long and doesn't happen toward the end of the album. For Dan, Mystic Familiar is a lot of familiar sounds, ideas, concepts, but now just executed at a higher and slightly more psychedelic level, to the point where there are tracks on this thing that slightly remind me of the Polyphonic Spree back when they were a lot more relevant, or even Flaming Lips. In fact, some of Dan's singing on this record is very, very, very similar to that of Wayne's. And even though Dan primarily employs electronics on this record, there are some aesthetic similarities between him and the Lips on this LP too, like on the track Wide-Eyed, especially when the vocals kick in on the second half. Even on the opening track too, Become a Mountain, which is euphoric, beautiful, wondrous, a piece that builds up some very gorgeous tension with these punctuated piano phrases, and like the post-minimalist that he is, Dan starts layering this phrase with numerous others until they just start swirling together into a magical display. It gets thicker and thicker and thicker, reaching amazing heights in the last 1 minute and 30 seconds of the track, where these orchestra-sized tones start enveloping the entire thing, sounding like a tractor beam dragging the entire piece up into an awesome alien ship. And if we observe some of the lyrics that Dan has laid into this track too, it's all pretty surreal and matches the tone of the instrumentation. The song Hypnagogic is a cool little transition piece, bringing us into Sat by a Tree, which is loaded with cycling beats, psychedelic tones. In one sense, it does remind me of like an Animal Collective track, but honestly, it's Dan being true to form over pulsing rhythms and rushes of synths and bass. The vocals calling out in this mess of sound in a very goofy, feel-good kind of way. There is a strong sense of place with this track too. When Dan is at his best, it sounds like a beautiful gate is being opened into a wonderland of sound, and I'm just allowed to prance my way through it as I please. The following track, Wide-Eyed, kicks off the four-part ARP piece that I mentioned earlier in the middle of the project. The whole thing accounts for about a quarter of this album's runtime, which is fine, doesn't take up too much space, but still, having all of these tracks connected does create a certain level of expectation. If one track is not all that great, all of them sort of suffer by virtue of being put together in a way. There's nothing worse than a buildup that leads to a very disappointing climax. And in my opinion, Wide-Eyed is a pretty good buildup. But there is a point at which the following track, Float Away, does get a little tedious and stale, where the progression of the glistening tones and busy beats just starts to slow and Dan's vocals, his vocal melodies, just meander. Especially when his singing comes back after an instrumental breakdown in the second half that sounded originally like it was going to build into a grand finale or something. The next movement, Far From Sure, while it's not as straightforward, it is more gratifying with its massive build toward the finish and its extended and wild sax intro. The last part of the piece is pretty much a cool down moment, a interesting display of sonic disintegration, just breaking the piece down into atoms before your ears to just let it play out, though I don't know why this needed to be broken down into its own track. I can't ever imagine myself skipping to this track specifically. Weeping Birch is another moment where Dan flexes his minimalist muscle with all of these cycling string phases playing out into a subtly psychedelic oblivion. Nothing in terms of a grand climax on this track, but it is a beautiful progression, and some of the melodies, which are reliant on a lot of elongated notes on this track, do live up to the title of the song. It does kind of create the sensation of weeping. Meanwhile, Fell Into the Ocean is a fun piece of indie-tronic pop with more of those minimalist elements that Dan is known for. What ultimately makes the track stick out is Dan's very fun and creative approach to a call-and-response chorus.
Dig deep!
The water deep down is safe enough to drink. Adds quite a bit of character to the track and keeps the whole thing from feeling samey. However, I think the track My Friend is a little by the numbers for Dan. I will say, though, I think the build and the flow of the song is something that Dan has kind of mastered at this point. It is quite good and keeps me on the edge of my seat as he just intensifies, de-escalates, weaving in some vocals too to keep the energy high. The song Bumblebee Crown King is a lot more ambitious by comparison. Lots of explorative lead melodies swimming through a sea of buzzing, building electronics. Not super hooky, not super catchy, not direct in any way, but still a great finish for the record. An impressive display of Dan's ability to block together sounds and melodies like Tetris pieces. Overall, I think this is Dan's best LP in years, and easily one of my favorites that he's done so far. It didn't involve doing anything too different than what I typically expect of his music, just executing all of it really solidly with a great track list and a decent amount of variety across the album too. I'm feeling a light to decent 8 on this one. Transition, have you given this album a listen? Did you love it? Did you hate it? What would you rate it? You're the best, you're the best. What should I review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe and please don't cry. Hit the bell as well. Over here next to my head is another video for you to check out. Hit that up or the link to subscribe to the channel. Anthony Fantano, Dan Deacon, forever.